गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक। वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट 13 चैप्टर, दैट इज डेटा इंटरप्रिटेशन। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट द डेटा इज। द कलेक्शन ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन इज कॉल्ड डेटा। वी नो इन आवर डे टू डे लाइफ वी गेट इंफॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग टेम्परेचर, रेनफॉल, मार्केट रेट्स ऑफ गोल्ड, सिल्वर करेंसी, पेट्रोलियम ऑयल, पल्सेस, वेजिटेबल फ्रूट्स एंड एक्सेट्रा through newspaper, television, internet, etc. So this only, the information, the collection of information is called data. And data can be represented graphically to give a clear idea, okay, of what it represents. So it will be helpful to interpret and organize the data using pictorial representation. Understood? So we will see what the pictorial representation is. See, with this diagram we can understand the representation of data using the pictures and symbol is called the pictograph. Okay, with this example we can understand. See, on Monday these many number of LEDs sold, on Tuesday these many are sold, and on Wednesday these many. So in this way we will understand. And they have given that one LED is equal to, the picture of one LED is equal to two LED. Okay, so with the help of this we understand the data clearly. So this we call it as the pictorial representation or a pictograph. The representation of data, it is the important definition. The representation of data using pictures and symbols is called pictograph. Okay, now see, this is the bar graph. Bar graph means a graph which displays information using bars or rectangles is known as bar graph. Okay, here we require two axes. This one is x-axis and this is the y-axis. So both the information are given on both the axes. So with this we can understand or interpret the information given using these rectangles, or we can say bar. Hence we call it as a bar graph. Understood? So this is the bar graph. Now the pie chart. What is pie chart? A pie chart or a circle graph is made by dividing a circle into the parts or the section, and it is used for comparison of a part to the whole. Okay, it is used for the comparison. See, with this example, saving 15%, medicines 10%, miscellaneous 10%, rent 10%, food 25%, clothes 10%, and education 20%. So starting this pie chart we can interpret the data. Okay, so this is a pie chart. Now tally charts. What are tally charts? See, when the observations are large, when we are using tally charts, when the observations are large, so it is not easy to find the frequencies by simple counting. So we make the use of vertical bars. This is the vertical bars and we call it as tally marks. Okay, so these are the tally marks. With the help of these we understood the data, the big, the large observations. Okay, so these are tally charts. Hope you have understood the types, the various types of representations of data. Okay, thank you.